Hi, welcome. In this section, we're going to be demonstrating how you can set up your assignment on this learning management system. The first step is to turn editing on. And once editing is turned on, you scroll down or you navigate to the section where you want the assignment to appear, and then you add an activity or resource. And under the activity, under activities, you choose assignment and click on add. You're going to give the assignment a name. I've already given it a name, topic one assignment. And then you also give it a description. Now, the next thing you want to do is under the additional files, you can add files that explains what the assignment is all about, and you can even give the students a sample of what you're expecting from them. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is to put a time limit. I want this assignment to just be for a day, and the students submit the assignment by 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And then you also want to remind yourself, you want the system to remind you about grading. That is what we do under availability. Under submission type, we have file submissions already enabled. If you decide to use online text, it means that the students will type, then they can type their assignment and also submit. Maximum number of files upload, I would just simply choose one. I don't want them to submit more than one. And then the maximum size of file is 2 megabytes. Accepted file types allows you to choose the type of file you're expecting from the student, and if you leave it blank, they can submit any type of file. So if you click on choose, it shows you all the files that are available. You can decide to limit the student to a certain type of file. I will not do anything there. Feedback types, I always like to enable offline grading. Now comment inline, if you enable it, if you say yes, it means that you can annotate on these submitted files when they submit. Then submission setting, you want the students to verify that they submitted this assignment. Then you say student required to click on the submit button. Before the assignment is accepted, they have to click on submit button. But if you leave it as no, once they upload, it would be accepted. And require that student accept the submission statement. That is what I was trying to say. They accept that, okay, I did this assignment, but most of the time I just want you to just leave it blank, except if you're very sure that you're going to also notify your students that, look, you have to verify that you submitted this assignment. And if you enable that, the verification checkbox will show up. Attempt reopened, no. I leave it as never because I just want the student to submit and I don't want to open the attempt again. Group settings allows you to, if you have a group on the system, then the students can submit in groups. Notification, of course, it's to help you to notify graders that it is time to start to grade the students. And you can also leave it as default. I think the settings there is just okay. Grade allows you to choose the type of grading method you want to use, and then also the grading style. You can decide to use scale or point. If you leave it as point, you can change the score there. If you have set up the grade book under grade category, you can select the grade book category for the assignment. And then the grading method allows you to choose what kind of method of grading you want to use. Is it rubric, marking guide, or simple direct grading? Ensure that you know exactly what you're doing if you're selecting any of these options. But we'll leave it as simple direct grading that allows us to just grade directly without much. If you use rubric, ensure that you also tell the students what you expect from them, and then it's a lot easier. Other settings there, I would leave it. Anytime you're on Moodle and you feel you're a bit confused, you can always use this question mark to guide yourself and then to tell you what you're supposed to do at that time. Now, also common Moodle settings. While you're setting up, you want to hide it from the student, you can decide to hide it from the student. Or alternatively, if you decide that I want this assignment to appear when the time, I don't want them to even see the assignment note. I don't want them to see the description until I'm ready for them to see it. You can hide it. And when you want them to see it, they can go ahead and see it. Let's take, for instance, you want the students to start assignment by 5 o'clock. I want the assignment to close by 6 o'clock on the same day. And you want them to just see the assignment at that very time and do it within that period that I've just mentioned. And you can do it anyhow it works for you. But take note and ensure that you know what you're doing when you're doing this. Now, restrict access. Of course, I've said it before in my previous videos that restrict access allows you to guide the students. If you're saying that the students must have read a particular note on the topic before they can take this assignment, or maybe they are supposed to have completed a particular activity, then you use restrict access. Then activity completion. Activity completion allows you to also track the students, to track this activity. Now, we're going to say that out of the three conditions here, I like to use show activity as complete when conditions are met. Student must view this activity to complete it. And then student must submit to this activity to complete it. And once you've set that, you can just simply save and display. And the moment you've done that, the first thing that shows up is the assignment description is there. If you have uploaded the file, it will also show up. And then you can see the number of participants. You can see that we don't have any submission yet. And what number of submission needs grading. So we have also seen that. And then the time remaining and then the due date is also showing. Now let me also quickly talk a little bit about other settings. You want to go back and make some correction, you can click on this gear button here that takes us to where you can actually go back to the edit settings. Under user overrides, maybe a student has not submitted and you want to grant that student the permission to submit. Just that student, you can use user overrides. Now, if I click on user override, for instance, and I click on add user override, you will see that it's assignment submission form is showing up, due date is showing, cutoff date is showing, and then you can just simply select the student in particular. This one allows you to just attend to a student per time. You can have more than one user override, of course. Now, once we're done with that, you can go back to this assignment page, and then other settings are there, but what you're most concerned with is to view all submission and then to download all submission. Now that we don't have any assignment submitted, we'll not be able to download. But let me just quickly go to one of the students enrolled into this course. I think I've already prepared a student already, and this student is waiting. And so if I refresh this page one more time, and then we can see that assignment topic one is showing. The student clicks on it, and then you can quickly add his submission. And once you click on add submission, he can navigate to where the assignment he has and upload it. Once it's saved, now once this is done as a teacher, you come back and then you refresh the page. Obviously, you can see that we have one submitted. And the next thing to do is to view all submission. Once you, on this page of view all submission, you can check. So we have a submitted assignment. We have a student who have submitted assignment. And so without wasting much time, you can just go up again and then under grading action, you can download all the assignments. Once you have received all the assignments, you can download all the assignments. And then you can see that we have a zipped file. And then you can also go ahead and download the grading worksheet. Now, once this grading worksheet is downloaded, you can go ahead and view what the student submitted. A folder is created for every student. A folder is created for every student and their name is appended on each of the folder. And then you can open the folder and see what the student actually submitted. And also, you can also open the Excel document. The Excel document will display their names and other things that they have submitted. Click on grade. And then you can decide to also do grade the student direct. We can decide to add a grade for the student. save changes. Once we save changes, we can see that the student has been graded 80. You can also give feedback. Remember we said feedback comment, we enabled feedback comment. Feedback comment, you can use video, you can use audio, you can insert a video, you can insert an image, you can go back to the assignment. And then you can see that immediately we've done that, needs grading becomes zero. And thank you for watching this video. I would appreciate if you can subscribe and also click on the bell notification so that you can get to know about new videos when we upload. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day.